All right, welcome back to our show. I'm very excited to welcome our next guest, who's known by many names. Office Monkey, Cozy Car, The Duke, Cozy Duke. But most of you know him by one name and one name only. Please welcome Mr. Cozy Bear!
Hey, great to see everyone.
Great to see you, Cozy Bear.
Great to be here, Jim.
Cozy Bear, it's been quite a few wild years for you, has it not?
It has. It really has, Jim. But, you know, I worked hard to get
That's what I was going to say, Cozy. You've been undermining diplomatic organizations and governments around the world for almost a decade now, right?
Oh, yes, Jim.
From what I understand, it's not really known how long you've actually been in business. In our research, sources said maybe even since 2010, but no one really knows.
My little secret.
Now, you've been found in some of the same cyberspaces as Julian Assange, Mini Duke, Onion Duke. Are you doing God's work, as some would say?
I don't know if I'd go that far. Try not to let it get
Well, Cozy, the American people have questions. Questions to which you hold the answers. Now, up to this point, you've cryptically kept your identity and true purpose, cloaked in anonymity and anti-detection software. But now that we've got you here, you know, the Cozy Bear, are your services for sale to anyone who's paying regardless of ideological stance?
I have many clients.
The Kremlin being one.
I don't divulge my clients' identities. In the business that I'm in, it's bad for
them. Okay, but subverting democracy has been your product, no? What did you gain from interfering in the 2016 United States election? And do you look forward to the repercussions of your actions?
Well, the situation is a tad more complicated than you might think. All through history, there have been imperial powers that bowed to special interest, only to serve themselves and dictate what other countries can and cannot do. You know, your American good guy, bad guy righteousness is steeped in ignorance and bias. Until you can think from a place where your morals, American morals and actions, are and have most of the time been at the south end of the compass. Until you can consider that, there's very little to talk about.
All right, don't take the bait. Don't take the bait. Keep this fish on the line before you reel him in. If need be, we'll go to commercial, but don't worry, don't take the bait.
Well, only God can judge, Mr. Cozy. It's not my place to say what is righteous about America's existence and what is shameful. But your actions have been in direct violation of the UN Security Council, you know, a group of nations aiming at establishing rules of engagement and guidelines for geopolitical interactions.
Well, if you know your history, as I'm sure you do, then you know that the Federation seceded from the UN almost 30 years ago.
Yes, a move which some argue was illegal and in direct violation of the UN Charter.
Well, Russia was the lifeblood of the Soviet Union, and Moscow doesn't recognize the authority of your super government, so the UN is irrelevant.
How the fuck?
So you play by your own rules.
I do.
So does our next guest. He's gone by such names as Strodium, Pawnstorm, and Sednit, but to us, he is the one and only Fancy Bear. Please welcome Fancy Bear! Please, have a seat. Good to see you, Fancy Bear.
You know, I never expected this kind of amateur gotcha journalism from you.
There's bad blood between you two. You are competitors, but you're both imperative to the discussion if the American people are going to get answers about what really happened in the 2016 election and what role the Kremlin played. What role both of you played.
My life's an open book, Jim.
Oh, God's sakes.
Fuck you.
Gentlemen.
Way to single-handedly bring down the level of discourse in record time. Are you sober or just an asshole?
You two have been historically adversaries. And the Kremlin knew this, but they enlisted both your help anyway, creating a competitive environment, further increasing the chances that the outcome of the election would be one that Putin wanted. Is this a sign that maybe you two will be working together again in the future?
Absolutely not.
Ah, come on, Cozy, give us a hug.
Don't touch me. Don't touch me.
We've already worked together.
I had no idea he was there, doing the same stuff I was, pulling the same key passwords, and basically duplicating my efforts.
When you say there, you mean within the Democratic National Committee servers?
Yes.
Hey, you think you're better than me, but you're not. I can do what you do and better and without the stuffy attitude.
I ought to bitch slap the stuffing out of you.
Try it, bitch. I'll cut your ass. You don't think I have a knife with me?
They say you got a knife. Jim, you see a knife in there.
We don't allow weapons in the studio, Fancy Bear. You should have been frisked and metal detected when you entered through security.
You don't know where I had to put it, Jim.
I think I'm beginning to see the sarcasm and irony of your name.
Fancy my ass. You're like the uneducated shitbags you helped.
You helped?
You are anything but fancy. Methinks the bear doth protest too much.
Hey, you helped them too!
Is cyber attack too inflammatory of a word for what you did what you both did in the case of the 2016 election, and do in general?
I don't think so.
Of course you don't.
If misinformation was the weapon, disseminated across multiple platforms, strategically by faceless agents, looking to derail democracy itself via the electoral process, then isn't it an attack?
I don't think so. Not in the conventional sense.
It's still war, no? Unconventional weapons such as sabotage, intelligence collection, and spying was utilized during the Cold War. Still a war. What's the difference here? Russia has a long history of utilizing these dirty tactics to influence geopolitics across the world. What do you think should be the reaction of the international community?
You're still stuck in your good guy, bad guy, American exceptionalism perspective, when in reality it is American imperialism. You all do the same and worse.
Turn it back on him.
Well, let us get back to the issue at hand. Vladimir Putin. He's rebuked the narrative that Russia had a significant effect on the outcome of the 2016 election, citing minuscule percentages of efficacy in the dissemination of information via Twitter and Facebook. He asserts that only 0.0016% of the information on Twitter, and even less on Facebook, was Russian-controlled, posing the question of why Mother Russia would take the time to dispense ads, memes, and clickbait in non-battleground states such as Texas, for example, where Trump had the vote locked in.
Good question.
Red meat, baby. This is where I shine.
Red meat.
Right. You push buttons that ignite the worst in voters, don't you, Cozy Bear? In the case of Texas, you gave them their favorite cuts of meat. Immigration, guns, vets, border security. All to inflame bipartisanship and open up the doors for people to hate other people they've never met, the majority of which they have more in common than not. You served the other side the same bipartisan stereotypes that allowed the left to think they know the right and hate them as well. All to blind voters in a fog that allowed discourse to sink to a new level of low. You targeted the information flow to specific audiences, giving them each the most hateful sides of themselves. It's toxic. It's toxic what you do, is it not, Cozy Bear?
I love you, sir.
If we can mold the conversation, the debate, by choosing the issues by which they judge the candidates, then is that any different than what Fox News does, or MSNBC for that matter? We just magnified what you all pump onto the air night after night.
Is it fun to watch the world burn, though? Some men just want to watch the world burn.
This is why I can't work with him. You have no integrity and will work for anyone. You're like a fluffy mercenary.
Get it back on track. We got less than a minute to commercial.
But like he said, Cozy Bear, you helped them too. Are your services for sale no matter the ideology they further? Do you have any allegiance to any country or state? Who do you work for? Because if it's Russia, then it's war. If it's for us, then it's treason.
I do my work with integrity. He's just an anarchist.
You flirting with me?
In your business, we find what is called contagion, Cozy Bear.
And in yours.
This tells us that social media users are more likely to mirror in their own posts the emotions they are exposed to in other people's posts, becoming quote-unquote infected, should we say, with the emotion, particularly negative emotion.
Hate is contagious.
Republican strategist Patrick Ruffini has been on record stating the following about the messaging you both amplified. He says, the subject matter was designed to engage extremist voices on the political fringe, not persuadable voters undecided between Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton. Where Russia appears to have made more headway before and after the election is in further animating partisans, capitalizing on their need to have their existing beliefs confirmed. It didn't matter that those confirming their beliefs were foreign adversaries.
Exactly.
But
the bigger picture here, gentlemen, is that you are poisoning society.
I love this.
Gloria Steinem wrote that humans, quote, come equipped with empathy, and that it is nurtured and developed by being in the same room with others, not by interactions over screens or the net. What we experience as children is ingrained and normalized within each child. Is this the new normal, gentlemen? Should our children grow up thinking this hate is normal?
Please, you think the world is candy and rainbows. It's a tough world out there. We're hateful beings who go to war and fight for resources, and I love it.
This guy's a sick fuck, man. We're gonna talk to
these are ideological grounds for war, though.
And resources.
You think we're the first ones to capitalize on partisan divisions?
Yes.
In this country, to this magnitude, yes. And the result is real people physically hurting each other. Charlottesville is the result, to put it mildly.
Oh, please. I can't be held responsible for every psycho out there who goes off.
Yes, you can. Your words, your irresponsible twisting of reality and perception allows people like James Alex Fields Jr., Dylan Ruth, and Robert Gregory Bowers to punish people you have told them deserve it. You should have to face the family members of Heather Hare and the victims who were worshiping at the Tree of Life congregation during Shabbat morning services. But you don't have to, do you? Agents like you just creep in through the dark back channels and psychologically manipulate others for the benefit of your employer. So who do you work for? Who do you work for, sir? Who?
Donald Trump.